Hey, so I picked up one of these StingRay by Music Man, StingRay 5, no. Yeah, Sterling by Music Man, StingRay 5 basses. I'm gonna turn off this light. Yeah, off the musician's friend, Deal of the Day, for $300. It's all right. I basically just grabbed it because it was cheap, and with the current gig I'm doing, I like needed a backup 5-string bass. I don't have any backup 5-string basses. I've got a couple of 4-strings. I have like 3 or 4 more 4-strings than I really need or use, but I didn't need a. I don't have any backup 5-string. My main 5-string is a Carvin LV75 from about the year 2000. I bought it right around there, right around the Y2K, but I'm not exactly sure exactly when, but it was right around then. So I needed a backup 5-string for the gig I'm doing currently, because I have a lot of these songs that are transposed down keys because of the vocalist, and you need to be able to play it like in the key, you know, without playing it up an octave on a 4-string. So I like having the 5, and I didn't have a backup 5, so I grabbed this thing for $300 when it was on sale. First thing I notice is the neck feels like a baseball bat compared to my Carvin. Like, it's really round. It's really round and thick, and just a big neck. Almost feels like playing an upright or something, like with the neck being so round, which is all right. It's just different. Not sure that it's worse or better or anything. It's just different than what I'm used to on my Carvin. There's that. I mean, the sounds are all right. The pot's a little noisy. Well, it's not going to do it now, but when I first started turning this volume pot, it was a little noisy. So it seems like it's got active electronics, which I didn't even know it was going to have active, but it's got a volume, what I think is a like master bass, I think, and then a master treble. Nope, got those backwards. This is the master treble, and this is the master bass. So I'm gonna leave those right both centered. And it's got this 5-way pickup selector switch, which is kind of weird the way it works. So like, took me a minute to figure it out, but it's like, let's see, it's got, so I like it in this position, which is one click right of the far left, but which gives me, this pickup and this pickup, or this coil, I guess, in this coil. So like a narrow spacing jazz bass, I guess, would be what that would be like. So, right? So it's like this one and this one, but it's kind of weird the way this works. So it's like, if I go this way, I have just these two and then nothing over here, right? Nothing's happened there. I go this way, I've got just these inner two. Right, then I go in the middle, it's the, everything's on. So all 4 coils are active. I go one this way, this is where it's just the outside, but nothing in the middle two. And then I go full here, and then I'm like, right, both of these coils, so it's just full humbucker over here. So it's kind of an interesting switch combination. I've never had a bass like that. I've never really seen that before, but it took me a minute to figure out what was going on there. But I like the sound of it the best right here. So one in, which is these two inner guys. Um, some, some like warmth and some roundness to it. It's not like totally bassy, but it's got like, you know, a good amount of bass. It's not like ultra like mid-range punch. I found up here, like if I go this pickup soloed, it's super loud. It's distorting everything. And it kind of just sounds bad. So I'm not going to do that. Centered is also kind of loud. It's nice and round. It's not too bad. But it's also distorting a lot and don't really care for that one as much. Here, it's cleaner. So this is the this spot right here, right, is the two outside guys, but not the two inside guys. That's actually not bad. I would deal with that. Not bad for some slapping, but it's all right. And then finally here, it's this pickup full on. Distorted is crap and sounds bad. So, yep, right here. That's the one I find to be the most usable, right? Everything else, I probably could dial it in, but whatever. This is the one that works the best for me right there. I'm gonna turn that volume down a little bit too. I don't like it up quite that high. So these two are flat, the EQs are flat, and the volume is 3/4 or so. All right, that's a usable tone. I could play that. Messing around here just to hear the tone, but so yeah, that's the electronics on it. From an action point of view, it's high. It's like way higher than I'm used to. But it's pretty clean sounding. There's like not a lot of buzz or anything, so I bet I could go lower and get a little. And be all right with it, but it's high. It's like, yeah, I don't know how high it's, but it's high, way higher than I like. But it's a $300 bass. I guess that's what you get. Let's see what else. The neck's pretty straight. There's not a lot of gap here. So if I'm like fretting at the first fret and some of these frets up here, you know, 15th or so. Wherever I'm at, you know, there's not much of a gap. Pretty straight. A little bit of a gap. So I would say the, you know, without getting out gauges and stuff, the truss rod's probably fine. Is that okay? Yeah, you know, other than that, it is what it is. It weighs. I would say it's pretty comparable to my walnut carving as far as weight. It doesn't feel that much different. There's no like major neck dive or anything crazy like that. It's just, you know, it just feels like a bass. The weirdest thing is this, the neck just feels thick. It's just a heavy neck. So I was working on a tune here. What is this tune? This is a Smooth Operator. I was working on that. I'll play that and play along to it and just like give this bass a little go and see how it goes. So I just got this bass today, actually last night, but really just playing it for the first time today. So, you know, we'll see how this goes. Thank you. So I didn't play that perfectly, I know, but it's been a while, and it's first time I'm trying it with this space, so it's all right. The space, you know, it's all right. It's the $300 bass, but it's playable. I'd do a gig with this, you know, like I'd play a gig with this tomorrow, and like wouldn't be too upset about it anyway. Like, I don't think it's as nice as my Carbon, but like it paid a lot more for my Carbon, so this one would work. It's a good backup. It's a fine bass for the price, but it is what it is. All right, cool. Later.